Hey everybody, it's Glenn, back in this video, rocking my new Star Wars jumper I got for Christmas and sharing with you the very best and worst action figures of 2015. Kicking it off in this video with the five worst, and I should say this isn't some big industry-wide survey I've undertaken, it's simply the action figures that made my boat float, or in this case, considering the worst, sank my ship in 2015. And this is part of a longer conversation I had with my good friend Craig on our podcast, Articulation Assembled. At number five, I am going for Marvel Legends. Which one will the finger fall on? I'm going for Marvel Legends Hawkeye from the
Odin Allfather Wave.
Yes, that one.
That's the purple classic Hawkeye with the metal arm.
Yep.
What the fuck's wrong with that?
Doesn't match the other arm.
What's wrong with his arm being a foot longer? That's the one he uses the bow on. It's obviously going to be bigger.
I realise I'm probably going to be more a lone opinion on this because I reviewed it, hating it, and, you know, read the comments.
And then hung yourself. And you're just a ghost at the moment. You're a force ghost.
It was a wave of like, what are you talking about? It's Hawkeye. It's awesome. Like, no, I hate it. I hate the arm, the face I hate.
Yeah, his face is like a grumpy old man.
Yeah.
It's like that Magneto figure, but he's put the Hawkeye mask on.
It's like if I had a Halloween party and my dad cosplayed. If my dad came as Hawkeye, knocked on the door, I open it, that is what my dad dressed as Hawkeye would look like.
Your dad's pretty ripped. Figure.
I don't even see it as ripped. Like
he's
like covered with like a weird plastic thing that levitates like
that's true.
Half an inch off of his shoulders.
His bib sort of rides up on his chin.
I mean, my dad is just short of getting like a robotic right arm that's a foot longer than his left arm, away from being that action figure. And he's got a purple bow, which I hate.
Color coordinate, right?
No. No one can be a badass who is color coordinating their weapon to their costume. Like, that's anti-badassery, right?
I've never seen Hawkeye as a badass anyway. I don't know where people get that from. Is it the movie?
We're going to go back to me complaining about Age of Ultron. Because that's, you know, I was happy with Hawkeye not being in the first one.
Uh-huh.
And then so much of the second one was like, oh, this is a correction. We're giving you more Hawkeye because you wanted it. And I'm like, no, I didn't. Number four, you might not get this because you're not a wrestling guy.
Okay.
But you will know this name, Hulk Hogan. Defining moments, Hulk Hogan.
Now, is he the one with the feather boa?
No.
Okay.
Are you referring to Hulk Hogan or just the specific
action figure?
Okay.
Yeah, I wouldn't say like, out of all the wrestlers, is Hulk Hogan the one that has the feather boa?
I thought you might be. I was like, oh no.
Well, which one's that?
We'd waited a really long time for Mattel to do a Hulk Hogan figure. You know, the biggest icon in wrestling, without a doubt.
Mm-hmm.
Contractually, he'd been tied up with TNA, which meant that the WWE couldn't use his image.
Yep.
And we'd waited so long, and the Hulk Hogan we got just wasn't the Hulk Hogan that I had in my head.
Right.
I think it was the expectation. It's hard to describe because a lot of people do really like this Hulk Hogan. I wanted it to be a big slice of my childhood in 7 inches of plastic.
Right.
And it just didn't feel that way to me. And I can't really put any finger on like...
Is he the one with the shirt that he can't tear?
Yes.
Right. And he's tearing it on the package?
Yeah.
See, I do watch the reviews and I'm like, oh, okay. Right.
Well, thank you for watching them.
A thumbs down them all.
As long as I get your fraction of a cent for watching it, I'm happy. But yeah, there were other Hulk Hogan action figures. I think the one that was from the Target exclusive Hall of Fame series that washed ashore in Smith's.
Is that the one with the feather boa?
No.
Oh.
That's the red jumpsuit, yellow cowboy boot look there.
Uh-huh.
That's my favourite Hulk Hogan.
Okay.
Like it captures that moment or that era, that time the best.
Smiling.
But it's still not the icon of Hulk Hogan that I want. And of course now...
You're not going to get that, are you?
Yeah. We won't be seeing a Hulk Hogan action figure for quite a while.
Until he's dead.
Yeah. And
even then.
They're certain there are no secret recordings of...
of him in the front row of the First Order. What's your number three?
I'm going back to Marvel Legends.
Okay.
And it's Valkyrie.
Valkyrie? Brunhilde.
Brunhilde. From Hulkbuster.
Yep.
Again, people seem to like this Valkyrie because it's better than the previous Valkyrie Hasbro that we got did.
Christmas
cracker. Which, in my opinion, is the very worst Marvel legend. And sure, it's better, but like being better doesn't make it good.
Yeah.
You know? Mm-hmm. And Hasbro were on a roll with redoing these females. Like their Black Cat in the Ultimate Green Goblin wave, I think is phenomenal. Like just wipes the floor with Toy Biz's Black Cat.
Yeah.
And I wanted this Valkyrie to do the same, and she just doesn't.
So what's wrong with her?
She's got like a giant head.
Yes.
That's like sitting on a giraffe neck.
Yes. And her hair is falling off the back. Yeah. You know? It's really weird.
Yeah.
It's not that women can't be not amazingly beautiful all the time, but...
Well, I mean, in comics, they kind of have to be. Yeah, it's the medium.
Valkyrie is that beautiful, so...
Yeah, just don't like it. Get it away.
Number two?
General Grievous from Disney Store's Elite series.
Oh, okay. Why would that possibly be? Is it because he doesn't work as a thing that stands up? He just...
Yeah. As a review I shot, completely frustrating. Completely unable to stand. General Grievous is not a character I even particularly like, but I'm a big fan of character designs, and I think his character design is awesome.
Uh-huh.
So I was excited for that one. So when you're excited for something, then it lets you down, it's even more impacting.
Yes. Yeah.
I know a lot of Star Wars collectors are very mint in package, mint on card.
Yeah.
For that,
God bless them, for that thing.
He looks fine.
Yeah.
And I'm not even, I wasn't expecting to do like Mad Sick ACBA with him.
Yeah,
like, I just want it to be able to stand up. Is that too much to ask for? Apparently.
And now's your number one. The horror.
We're here already. I was just getting my knives sharpened. Is the flying ant and Ant-Man.
Uh-huh.
Yep.
What's wrong with that? Well, I think we've all known.
It suffers from General Grievous syndrome, or General Grievous suffered from Antony syndrome. Yeah, I'm not sure which is which. But at least General Grievous looked good in packaging.
Yes.
Like, this flying ant just looked dire in packaging. Its legs are like, they couldn't even bother to cast them in plastic, so they hollowed them out. It's like, every fraction of a cent matters, you know? It's like if whatever Hasbro employee saves a fraction of a cent, they get like a $5,000 bonus. And it suffers from the General Grievous problem in that it can't stand up.
Mm-hmm.
It can't hold the weight of itself, let alone when you put Ant-Man on it, which is the point of the toy. And I was really excited for this coming out. I mean, I do like Ant-Man, but more than that, when I saw it, I kind of got Sektor's flashback, which is 80s toy line, if you're not familiar with it, which really isn't that well remembered compared to like other 80s. Mm-hmm. It was more of a blip.
Yes.
Like, it seemed to happen and then just completely went away.
Yep.
But they were all insect-based action figures, and they had steeds that were gloves that you put your hand into. You'd mount like a
figure
spider
on
guy on it and then charge around the house and your mum would shout at you. So it made me think of that, which a nostalgic twinge is always a good thing as an adult collector when you see something. But then in practice, it just fell apart. And to me, it's a toy that I think should have been recalled. It's absolutely not fit for purpose. Uh-huh. The Star Wars Elite series with Grievous is an adult collector thing.
Yeah.
You know, how many of those are even going to come out of that box? That flying ant, like, that is a children's toy intended for children.
Yeah.
And as pissed as I am as an adult collector personally for me having spent money on it, I'm annoyed for children because I know it's not going to be fun for them to play with.
Yeah.
And that's despicable. Thank you. So those were my five worst purchases this year. We could consider them the class of 2015 in an action figure hall of shame. I'd be interested to know what were your worst purchases. Let me know in the comments beneath this video. Then it's onwards and upwards, as in my next video, I'll be sharing my five best action figures of 2015. And for the kind of talk you heard in this video, you can hear regularly on my podcast, Articulation Assembled. It's available on iTunes, Stitcher, and SoundCloud. Links to all those in the description beneath this video. Go give it a listen. and I hope to see you in my next video. Bye.